We've got the Super 20s series starting here today. Myself, Simi Kefu, and joined by Sam Phillips.
Test one. I can't hear me.
Hello.
Yeah, test one two.
Simi Kefu with news. Hello. Hey. Yeah, we can hear everything, Paul. Swear words. Hello and welcome to Rugby.com.au. My name's Simi Kefu and I'll be helping you with all the commentary in today's rugby action. We've got the Queensland Under-20s taking on the Melbourne Rebels Under-20s. Stay tuned, kickoff is not far away. Stay with us.
When you're ready.
Hello and welcome to Rugby.com.au. My name is Simi Kefu and I'll be helping you with all the commentary in today's rugby action. Today we've got the Queensland Reds Under-20s taking on the Melbourne Rebels Under-20s in a clash here in sunny Brisbane at Crosby Park, home of the Brethren. Kickoff is not far away, so stay tuned for all the action. To the footage here, right here on rugby.com.au. My name is Simi Kefu and I'm joined here with Sam Phillips. Today we're covering all the Super 20s action. We'll be watching the Queensland Under-20s take on the Melbourne Rebels Under-20s. Sam, how are you feeling, mate?
I'm feeling good, Simi. It's good to be here, mate. It's an absolutely beautiful Brisbane day. The sun is out. Everyone, there's a fairly good crowd here for a 12 o'clock start, and I'm looking forward to some 20s footy, mate. How are you feeling?
Mate, it's a scorching hot today, but I feel sorry for these guys. But look, they're young blood. They should be able to handle it. It should be exciting. You know, obviously, last night we saw the Reds get underway, the St. George Queensland Reds get underway, and they did really well to snitch a two-point win over the Sharks, which was good. And look, this is the next generation. That's what we're talking about. This is the next up-and-coming talent that we will be seeing at Suncorp Stadium later on.
Yeah, there's some famous names here, especially for the Queensland boys. We've got Scott Young, Angus Scott Young, Harry Nusafora and Alex Horan all on the Queensland team sheet. So the next generation going to be in action here today.
And hopefully they can produce some amazing talent like their relatives have once before. So, here at Crosby Park, home of the Brethren, we've also got the Australian Championships later on today. And we'll just see the Rebels lining up, the Rebels Under-20s lining up, ready to go. And here we go. We've got Liam Wright leading the Queensland Reds Under-20s out to the field. Kickoff is just about to get underway. The Rebels have kicked off. The Queensland Reds, the Queensland Under-20s have picked it up. Good receive by number 5, Harry Hawkins, former Churchy student.
It's a great start for the Rebels there. It's a good carry by the Reds 12, Tony Hunt, but yeah, he was isolated, and the Rebels have gone straight over the top of it, and you think they might take a shot here.
We'll stop for some injury time.
Doesn't look good. Might be a shoulder.
Not in the opening minutes. Devastating for the Rebels here. Rebels under 20s.
So, Simi, your thoughts on the game last night, mate? You were there. How did you did you think the Reds were going to get there?
Look, the St. George Queensland Reds did a really good job. They took opportunities that they should have, and you know, they played some smart rugby. They took shots. They couldn't stop that Patrick Lambie Sharks, fly half who just kicked him from everywhere. I think he only missed one kick. He only missed one kick last night. So, you know, they did everything they could to stop him. But the silly mistakes, obviously giving penalties away, doesn't really help their cause. But look, they came home with a 2-point win, which is, mate, a win's a win. So especially in preseason, you want to get that momentum. You want to roll over. You really want to. Set the pace for the 2017 season. So, and I think they did that really well last night.
So they're calling for the stretcher here. It's not a great start to the match. First game of the under 20 season, and we've got an unfortunate injury here. But
they'll be a bit devastated here. It's only been the first minute of play, and already they look like they've got a serious injury underway.
Just looking at that replay, it's a great work there by Essie Hangana, who was right over the ball from the outset and was really strong there. Two or three Reds tried to clean him out, but was too strong over the ball, which is not something we saw much of last night, actually. So it's good signs for Melbourne early.
Oof, we'll be seeing him stretch it off now, unfortunately. Can't get a number.
Yeah, not quite sure who it is at this stage, but once we get a number, we'll let you know.
Literally, like the opening minutes, and we're only 43 seconds in. The Queensland Reds under 20s have to recoup, they have to come together. It's not only a negative thing for the Rebels under 20s, it's also the Reds under 20s as well, because you know, they've got to reset themselves, they've got to get back to where they were at the start of the game. You know, a break like this, could rock them a little bit.
Yeah, exactly right. It's almost having to start all over again. Sometimes you see teams bring a ball out and run some drills when there's a stoppage of this sort of length. But it's just more about making sure the right precautions are taken so the players taken off safely and there's no further harm done. So thoughts and prayers with this player at the moment.
We'll see him being stretched off shortly. What a cracking day. I don't even want to know how hot it is out there. These poor blokes under 20s. Some scorching heat out there,
yeah,
isn't it?
So coming on was Sunia Fini Fiukai.
It doesn't look good.
And the Rebels are taking a shot. Harrison Goddard will take the penalty, which Hangana won earlier.
It's interesting to see also with the Melbourne Rebels under 20s. We've got a lot of Brisbane players that have sort of shuffled down there and picked up opportunities. You know, we've got a lot of GPS people that have gone down from school. We've got about eight players in the Melbourne Rebels team that have actually come out of the GPS system. So it's good to see where all the talent's being, you know, sort of built.
Queensland-based, mate.
Queensland-based. And penalty kicks and successful. The score is the Melbourne Rebels under 20s 3, Queensland under 20s 0. We're back to reset here for the kickoff.
Back underway.
Good catch by number 17 here, Melbourne Rebels under 20s. They'll pass it out. Good defence there by Queensland under 20s. Clear kick.
Good box kick. Been a Manu to clean up here. It's a great kick.
It's a good kick. That's well placed. See a line out coming up.
A it's Goddard again there, who's nailed that first penalty, hit it pretty well, and he's obviously hitting it well in general play as well. It's a very good start for him.
See the line up, line out, go up. Queensland under 20s taking it up. Big number 12.
It's Tony Hunt again.
Tony Hunt, former Nudgee College graduate. Got number 10 here. Melbourne Rebels. Clear pass to the middle. The fullback.
It's McGregor now over to Clarkin.
Coming back the same way from Samisi Tupou.
Great defence there.
The ref has called a penalty awarded to the Queensland under-20s team.
Big shot by Gavin Luca and Etifusi Mafu there for the Reds.
Done well on that pronunciation.
Very physical.
Yes, Sam. I'll have to give you gold star for that.
Very physical young talent, Mafu, and he's made his impact be known early. So let's see how this line out.
Melbourne lining up. Melbourne lining up for the line out. Queensland under 20s walking it in. And we're up. Queensland under 20s have got the ball. They brought it back. Here we go. They've taken it up. Halfback is calling for the ball. He's passing it out. Number 5. Harry Hockings taking it up. Angus Scott Young, here we go. He's passing it right out to the middle of the field. Full half, good tackle there by the Melbourne Rebels under 20s. Midfield. They'll take it up. They'll take it from the back of the ruck. Here we see the Reds making momentum. Queensland under 20s making momentum.
Marfield again here. Oh, I thought he scored that.
We're inches from the line. Queensland under 20s.
That's a try.
Dancing with... The ref has called a try. It's awarded it.
I think that was the overside flanker. It might have been the skipper, Liam Wright. Great start from the Reds. That was really good structured play. One off the halfback. The forwards trucked it up, did their job, and they were rewarded in the end with one of the forwards getting the try, so that's a really good start for the Reds. I'll be happy with that.
It was also some really good defence there from the Melbourne Rebels under 20s. They couldn't hold them off any longer. The forwards did really well to just keep trucking it up and keep that momentum. The score now is the Queensland under 20s 5, Melbourne Rebels under 20s 3.
Yeah, the Reds will be happy with how their forwards went there. They would really beat the Rebels forwards for the physicality at the breakdown and.
Bit windy out there. Nice, very windy. Harry Nusafora, poor bloke. He's only got a small time window to get that kick up.
For the next gust.
At least the sun's gone down a little bit. Conversion successful. Harry Nusafora. That will take the score. The Queensland under 20s, 7. Melbourne Reds under 20s, 3. The Queensland Reds ready to receive. Their forwards on the right-hand side of the field.
Boy dramas here.
Good pass there from the Brethren Junior. And the kick is off. Big bounce.
Scott Young.
Scott Young taking it up.
Great run.
Good ruck.
Did he call him more?
The fly half is
well
off.
Done. Yeah, I don't know.
Scramble water to the Melbourne Rebels under 20s.
It's a bit stiff there. I don't know how. Yeah, he was borderline more, but yeah, the Rebels, once they've heard that call, have piled in and they've won the ball back, so credit to them. It's the second time the Reds have tried to exit and they haven't been able to. The Rebels have really pounced on that aspect of their game so far, so that's really impressive. So let's see what they can do with some front football here.
The pressure is consistent, especially coming off a try against them. You know, they're sort of, they want to put one back right back on them.
100%.
So, good pressure by the visitors.
The Rebels coming out left now through McGregor.
Smithy Tupou on the wing, former Nudgee College graduate. He made a name for himself in the GPS system. We'll come back towards the middle now.
Great pass. Jeez, a big boy. Ooh.
Trucking that up. Here we go.
Was that not a knock
on? On the right-hand side. The ref hasn't put his hand up or anything. Try time to the Melbourne Rebels under 20s.
Quite
just
sure
a pick
that
and
was.
Go. Just a pick and go.
It's good footy. I thought that might have been a knock on there.
The Queensland Reds really need to tidy up that rack around the, you know, the one and two pillars. They really need to, you know, strengthen that up. That's exactly how tries like this have been scored.
Yeah, I think they're a bit rattled after that. After that, well, seeming drop ball, but as they say, she's always part of the whistle simmy, and they kind of stood off a bit, and the Rebels have taken full advantage. It was a really good try, and really impressed with McGregor there, the 10. He's really organising his side well, and he's got a good pass on him either side, so great start for him.
It's good for the Rebels, who they just sort of wanted to come and put the pressure back on straight away after that try was, you know, was scored against them. So they did a good job to come back.
It's big. Big Han Garner again there. He was the one who earned that penalty early on, which earned him their first points, and he scored him their first try, so he's off to a flyer. He's got Ard.
Conversion successful now. This takes the score up. Melbourne Rebels under 20s. 10. Queensland under 20s trail on 7.
Good contest so far, mate. Some good attacking footy.
Yeah, look, I think we're in for an interesting half. First half of footy.
Yeah,
mate.
Definitely.
Good take by the number 6 here, midfield. Throwing it to nowhere. A bit of a scuffle there on the left-hand side of the field.
It's a great run by Clarkson.
The Reds have got a big gap here on the left-hand side. Oh, but he's going to clear kick that.
It's a good nudge by McGregor.
Clearing to the midfield. Queensland under 20s. Good palm there.
It's Jaden Armani there in the
red. Straight down.
In the red squad. Very good talent.
There. Drop ball. Scrum. Awarded to Melbourne Rebels there.
It's a poor pass from Yusuf Fora. He'll be expecting better of himself there. It was right at the feet of...
There was pods there waiting for it as well. So
yeah, not ideal.
They were ready. See the Melbourne Rebels take the scrum. Come to the right side, a nice chip by the halfback.
It's got out again there. Very good. Really good positional awareness, and he's off to a great start here today.
Line out on the Queensland under 20s, 22 line. Queensland ball. So far their lineouts have done pretty good.
Yeah, Marfo's been good with the ball in hand for sure.
And we're up.
Better from Yusuf Fora.
And instead of the clear kick, the Reds have taken the option to just run it up with their forwards. The support there behind them.
Oh,
good clear kick there.
It's Clarkson. It's 3-on-3. Good ball.
Good offload. Good defence there by Queensland under 20s. We'll clear it out here. A tackle there.
Great pressure by Hunt.
Good pressure off that line. Seen the play early.
Yeah, he's picked out Hunt Garner there, Hunt. I don't think that was us, was it?
Yeah, no. Definitely not.
Yeah, it's like...
As I said, we were live. Anything can happen. That wasn't a swear, but a beep as well. No, we don't do that.
Wasn't Simi getting frustrated?
Not on the Simi and Sam show. Definitely not. We'll go down scrum here. Harry Nusafura feeding it in. The scrums have been pretty good so far.
Yeah, both teams pretty solid. Rebels might have the slight upper hand, potentially, but yeah, both teams would be happy with how their scrums performed.
Definitely bigger.
Yeah, bigger pack, some big big Islander boys in that pack there.
I don't know what they're feeding them down south.
Good feed down there.
Good feed down. We're in the 11th minute now. In the 12th minute, sorry. Harry Nusafura feeding the ball in now. Queensland number 20's ball and it's passed out to the right. Clear kick by number 10, Hamish Stewart.
That's a good kick. It's Clarkson.
And he's kicked it back. Clarkson.
It's not a good kick. It's a net win for the Reds.
Yeah. It's a bit windy out there today. Not only in sunny Brisbane, it's near 40 degree heat. There's also a bit of wind that's picking up.
Near 40, you reckon?
It's got to be. I don't know if the air conditioning that is broken.
The feels like temperature near 40.
Another consistent lineup by the Queensland Reds. Under 20s. Right up the middle.
We are.
Some early. A bit of a lift there in that tackle.
Oh!
Some good hands by the Queensland under 20s. Unfortunately, it didn't pay off. The ref is taking it back to a penalty.
Yeah, it's just above horizontal there. It's a good tackle, just took it a bit too fast. You can't do that in rugby.
No, definitely not. I think this year especially, they're going to be cracking down on a lot of those high tackles as well.
It's going to be a shock for Nusafura.
Anything from the chest up is now classified as a head high.
Yeah, we saw that last night, didn't we? There was a bit of a contentious decisions. The Reds had a couple of guys go to the bin where the Sharks didn't. But it's the new laws of world rugby is any contact getting near that shoulder height is 10 minutes. So
they were in full force last night. Yes, you're right. Kane Douglas coming off twice, actually. Go Harry Nusafura taking the penalty kick.
Just to level it up. Looks good.
And he's done so. Penalty kick successful by Harry Nusafura. The score is now Queensland under 20s, 10. Melbourne Rebels under 20s, 10 as well. 10 apiece.
Yeah, both teams kicking well. Both teams taking full advantage every time they go into the opposition sort of 30. They're getting points, so it's a good start for both sides.
10 apiece in the 14th minute of this half. Good clear kick there.
Great kick, Nusafura.
Great kick. And what's been really good today too as well in the first 14 minutes, mate, has been the Queensland under 20s lineout. It's been consistent. They've won every ball. It's good to see that they've sort of inbred that kind of, you know, consistency in them while they're young.
Yeah, Marfo's been great off the top.
Melbourne Rebels ball here will go midfield.
Knock on. Check. Reds ball now. Nusafura's
Reds
done.
Ball now. Check. Out to the left wing. Oh. Good take there. Good hit by... Big hit on Harry Hoopert.
Bit of shoulder charge or what? Yeah.
A few tackling technical difficulties on the Melbourne Rebels side. The ref is not letting anything pass.
Yeah, the Reds water boys were right into that touchy then. Ooh.
Get up, boys! Check.
Again, great line out.
Nice and quick. Midfield here, Queensland under 20s.
Harry Hooper.
Harry Hooper, good hit up.
Great, and getting through plenty of work.
Going straight out to the wing. That's Tony Hunt there. Good run by number 8.
Got to be a penalty.
He's everywhere today. Harry Hooper. Big run. And the ref is calling a penalty awarded to the Queensland under 20s side for offside.
Yeah, smart play by New Sephora. The Rebels forward sort of trailing back, getting in the way, and he just threw it straight into him, and there's no other option there but for the referee to award a penalty.
Mate, how's Harry Hooper, number one, mate, getting in the mix?
On fire. Him and
two touches in 2 minutes, that's great.
Him and Scott Young have had plenty of footy early, and they've really made an impact every time they've touched it. They've made sure they're getting over the gain line, getting their back some good, clean ball. So, yeah, they've been great.
Harry Hooper, former Toowoomba grammar student. It's good to see Toowoomba producing some good talent out in the regional areas. It's well spread across the state. Penalty kick successful by Harry Nusafora. That'll take the score to Queensland under 20s, 13, Melbourne Rebels, 10. See the forwards lining up on the right-hand side of the field. They have been doing that all week.
Yeah, it's the same kick every time.
Harry Hockings, good receive. Good clear kick by Harry Nusafora.
Kicking behind space. Oh, I don't know about that. Penalty advantage.
Ref hasn't called any advantage on that. Nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, no, he did.
He did. He's called it.
I thought he did. He stuck his hand out very briefly.
Penalty awarded to the Melbourne Rebels under 20s.
As we were saying before, just slipped up that shoulder, and you can't do that, unfortunately.
It's good to see they've made sure that it's, you know, they're not giving anything away. The refs are, you know, sure of the call.
It will,
as changing the game.
As a team, all you want is consistency. So if they're going to call it like that, as long as they call it like that for both sides.
And all the time, too.
Correct, yeah, they'll be happy. So, yeah, while it might not be the old school way of doing things, it's just how it's done in 2017, Simi.
That's it. New year, new game. Melbourne Rebels line out successful. Past midfield to that number 12. He's done some good work in the midfield. Angelo, Lau Pepe.
Gee, the Reds again at the breakdown all over it. Turnover ball.
Turnover ball. Finger. Queensland under 20s taking the ball. Heading out to the right.
It's on here.
Oh, he's dancing around the ball. He's got support there.
Superb work by Will Eady there.
Midfield hit up there by Angus Scott-Young. Good clear kick there by Hamish Stewart too.
Yeah, good option.
Perfect placement. Just 10 inside the 22-metre mark on the Melbourne Rebels under 20s trial line.
All set up by that 80 run there. It looked like the Reds might get away. The ball was at his feet, and he still managed to juke his way inside a few defenders and get the Reds back on the front foot. And Stewart's put a pinpoint kick in, so great stuff.
Advantage.
Sure, that's a knock on.
The ref did have his hand up for the knock on. He's changed his mind. Queensland under 20s ball. Good momentum after that big kick out to that line out.
Hoop it.
What a prop.
Oh.
Good run there.
Ma'afu,
good run there by Ma'afu. We'll go back to that knock on. Queensland under 20s.
Good chance for a backline play here. I'm interested to see what Stewart calls. He's got Big Hunt outside him. Dylan Riley outside him as well. So great attacking weapons. And Riley in particular has got a really good pass on him. If he brings Jaden Amanu into the play, it'll be interesting to see if the Rebels can hold him out.
It's good to see the Queensland team's, attention to the line-out, especially the defensive line-out as well. They've been winning every one of their line-outs and, sort of contesting every single Melbourne line-out. So, mate, they've done it. Whoever's been doing that, obviously the great Brad Thorne, who's just standing over there, assistant coach, has done a really good job with that.
Yeah, really done their homework on the line-out. Good scrum.
Good scrum out to the midfield.
Quick ball needed here.
Queensland under 20s ball. Midfield here. We're only about 15 metres out. Forwards ball, which always seems to be working, especially in the first 22 minutes of the game. Forwards ball again. Hoopit. Good run by Hoopit. And it's another forwards ball again. Maafu.
So let's call that first try.
This is a winning formula.
One out, pick and drive.
Good defence there by Melbourne Rebels. They've done a good job to keep them off, but, mate, the Reds are adamant on getting this. The forwards are just rolling around again and again and again.
Oh, he's lost it.
Oh, lost the ball. Melbourne's ball.
Jeez.
In goal.
You can't kick like that when kicking in danger, they'd call it in the AFL, and I think that's what it was there.
Ref's arms up, penalty awarded to Melbourne. I see a clear kick here. What good consistency there with, we've obviously saw that coming from the 22 line into the try line, the Melbourne Rebels try line. We made about 15 metres, which is great. They're working overtime, I tell you.
Yeah, it's poor. It's two lineups in a row. They've missed their throw, so it's got to be a bit better from the Melbourne Rebels hooker there. Young Callum Kent.
It's a nice and easy name to pronounce. Had a few South African names last night in the Sharks team. You don't
be tough
to know.
It's lucky they didn't score too many tries, really. Yes. It was just Pat Lambie.
Pat Lambie, which was great. They'll go in for a scrum. Queensland's feed.
Another strong scrum for the Reds.
Good offload to the winger there. Samuel Edwards.
First
touch of the game. The forwards are adamant on taking it up themselves. They've got the support. And why not? Melbourne Rebels.
Tom Garner again. That's the second time since the first half. He's won a penalty over the breakdown, so it's really good work from him. He's been good. He scored their only try as well.
Those forwards are working overtime on the Queensland side.
It's not out.
They'll be blowing. Not out. Good take by the wing there, Queensland's wing.
It's
midfield here.
Manu.
We'll come full length of the field. Across the sideline here, Red Queensland's ball. Going back to the middle of the field. We've got some forwards there waiting for the run. Here we go. Gavin Luca. Good hit up by Gavin Luca. He's been doing all the hard work around the rucks. Yeah. That was his first touch of the game. Still Queensland's ball. Unlucky.
It's a good day by the Rebels. I'll be happy with that. That was really solid. The Reds were pretty crisp with their passing and had some opportunities, but the Rebels just covered really well and were really good, and they deserved that knock-on, really.
A few of those forwards will be blown. It's first 25 minutes. We've got a substitution here, or
I think it's Hoopit might have a bit of blood.
That's Harry Hoopit. He's been a dominant force up front.
Yeah, he's been unreal.
It's been great.
Him and Scott Young have been exceptional. They've probably been the two best players in the park, I think. They've been really, really good, along with Hungana there for the Rebels, the big lock. He's been spectacular, but they'd be probably the best three players in the ground at the moment.
I'll have to agree with you there.
Is that right?
Doesn't happen often.
No, it doesn't.
But, no, Harry's hit-ups, mate. I'm a great supporter of all props and what they do.
You're too big.
Bit biased.
Aren't you too big to be a prop? Do you play props, yeah?
Yeah, I'm a prop.
You're too tall to be a prop.
I was once a little chubby, I was trained as a prop.
How's the South? Are you going around this year? Are you playing?
I'm not having a go this year, no. But Souths are looking pretty good this year. They've got Elliot Takiri looking after them, which is a good change for them.
Yeah.
They've got Van Humphreys, former Queensland Reds.
Yep. Stalwart.
Stalwart. They're looking pretty good. They've got some names. They've recruited well. Last year probably, you know, it wasn't the best year, but it was a good year.
Yeah.
They still sort of made semis and quarters, so that was a pretty good effort for any Premier Rugby club.
Yeah, of course.
We'll go back on to the scrum. Harry seems to be fine. The blood's sort of blended into his jersey, which is good.
Advantage of the red jersey, I suppose.
Advantage of the red jersey. It's all an optical illusion. Melbourne feed. Scrums have been good so far. Go midfield here. Still Melbourne's ball. Just keep feeding it up. Some big runs there. Number 13, Hunter Baisami.
Oh,
good intercept there. Good intercept there by Queensland under 20s, number 11.
Sam Edwards.
Sam Edwards, under the post. He just read it.
Superb. I was about to say it's a good ball by McGregor going for that option out there. It was a 2-on-1, but Edwards picked it off perfectly, and there's nothing really you can do when someone's that keyed on. So it's a great, some really good work there by Edwards, who just had his first touch about 2 minutes ago. So
I think a couple of the Queensland forwards will be happy with that, getting a bit of a breather. Sam Edwards, a fantastic, fantastic play, picking it early on.
Trying to go out wide there to his fullback.
Winger against winger.
Austin Clarkson, who's been good as well. And, yeah, he's just been picked off. It was really, really intuitive work by Edwards and well worth the 5 points. Well, 7 in a sec.
That will take the score up to Queensland under 20s, 18. Melbourne Rebels under 20s, 10. Conversion successful by Harry Nusafora. They will take the score up to Queensland under 20s, 20, and the Melbourne Rebels under 20s, 10.
Back underway. Back to Scott Young again. Trucking it up as he has off nearly every kickoff so far.
He's done really well in this game. He's just always been there, the forward that, you know, is at the ruck at the breakdown.
Done plenty of work. It's another good run if he goes down to ground here.
Ready to do that next pick and run. You see Harry pass the ball out. A clear kick here.
Good kick.
Good kick. And it's gone out just past the 22 metre line of the Melbourne Rebels under 20s try line. Good kick there.
Really, really good boot on Stewart. He's been a bit of a newbie in this 10 setup, Bon Uni product, and he's been really good today. He's organised the Reds really well, and kicks like that certainly don't hurt.
Definitely. It's only a positive thing for the team. And right, another good line out.
Oh.
Good pass out there to the Melbourne.
Great tackle, Edwards.
Big inside pass, and we'll have a turnover here for Queensland under 20s. Scott Young again. Got the ball. Another clear kick here.
60 metre Tory.
Another. Oh, unlucky. Knocked back by the Melbourne Rebels winger. He's running up midfield. On his own. On his own. Absolutely crunched.
Isolated and I've lost it. It's on. Oh.
Harry looking for that corner kick.
Gee, I reckon they had to run that there, Nusafora.
He's playing the knock on.
Lucky.
Some pretty impressive kicking there, Sam.
That's absolutely roosted that Hamish Stewart. He dead set kicked that 60 metres on the fly of that torpedo. So he's had that kick 2 minutes earlier with the drop punt.
With the drop punt.
Gone about 50 and he's hit it just as far with it. It was a torpedo. It was really, really good. So good signs there for the young 10. Some big hits there too. Great cover defence. Sammy Edwards scored that intercept try and he saved one at the other end here with the tackle on the Rebels, Rebels prop. So it's really good footy so far from the Reds.
It's good to see the combination as well with the forwards and the backs. We've got the backs obviously doing a great job with the kicking, but the forwards backing it up. You know, sometimes you never see that, the two complement each other, especially, you know, in a young game like this. So it's good to see and it's promising, obviously, for Queensland rugby future.
100%. Anything, if we get... If this is an indication of the top level talent in Queensland 20s and Melbourne 20s for that matter, they're playing great as well. It's really good signs for Australian rugby going forward.
Even a better sign when 8 of the Melbourne players are Queenslanders.
Queensland boys.
That helps. See your timeout. It's very hot out here today. The sun is beaming. Ref is calling it down. It is a scrum. Water to the Queensland. Oh, good tackle there by the Melbourne Rebels. It's good to see the fight in every single one of these tackles out there by one of these young fellas. They're doing such a great job around the rucks there. Oh, big tackle.
Great work, Liam Wright. Oh. Turn around like a
Harry going, Harry going left.
Oh.
And again. Oh.
Gee,
big tackle. And the ref has called a penalty. Awarded to Queensland.
You can see that hit coming from a mile away there. It was Hunter Hoisami.
We'll see the replay here.
Oh,
and he's just cleaned him out.
Absolutely.
Loose ball.
I think Dylan Riley would be a bit sore after that. That was a massive hit.
Hamish Stewart. Going for the line, which is a good option. Queensland's line out has been consistent throughout this whole half so far.
Look for a bit of a line out to the back, get some clean ball to Nusafora and let their backs run free here.
We've got less than 8 minutes left in this first half. Ma'afu feeding that ball.
Oh,
here we go.
Trick play.
Out to the front of the line out, and he's got it back.
Stay in.
He's taken it to the line, but Melbourne have held him off. Harry looking for another forward to pass it to.
Gavin Luca.
We've got Gavin Luca here. Big run by him.
Lost it.
Referee has called that knock on by Gavin Luca. Unlucky. So close.
Yeah, it's good footy. One of the Kiwi teams scored a try like that yesterday, actually. It was trick play off the line out, just when you expect.
Did it come off?
Yeah, it did. Hicker Elliott scored for the Chiefs, so. Yeah, just when you expect scrubs like me, expect you to go to the back of the line out and give the back some clean ball, you change it up. That's the way you score points in this game.
Good defence there by Melbourne. Not letting them come through that front gate. Good initiative by Ma'afu calling a line out. It's tricky going for a line out like that, especially when you're so close, whether you're going to risk it or not. Here we go. Melbourne ball. Geez, they're not small, are they? And a clear kick there by Melbourne, number 10.
McGregor.
Jack McGregor.
Yeah, quick ball.
Catch there, quick ball out to midfield.
3-on-1 out
We're
here.
We're heading back into the 30-metre mark. Reds Queensland ball.
Clean out by Stewart there.
Good tackle there. Head kick has just come off. Good sign of how hard these young fellas are hitting today. It's a lot of drop ball today, unfortunately.
He's called back.
Scott Young. Good run by Scott Young. He has been doing that all game. a little bit complacent. The Queensland team is a little bit complacent at the moment. They sort of just need to reset. Going left.
How good's Marfu been?
Marfu has just been so consistent throughout this first half. We're going left.
Oh, geez, missed some big hits here.
Clean out there. Dylan Riley on the end of that tackle. Queensland under 20s keeping that pressure on, and Melbourne Rebels have taken the ball.
Good kick.
They've done a kick. It's bounced up high, just past the halfway meter line.
Well done by Jaden Amanu there.
Good save by Queensland.
Gotta be Rebels.
Queensland ball.
That's unlucky.
Unfortunate. Penalty awarded.
Feet. He was there first, had all the rights, Hunter Paisami there, but he just couldn't stay on his feet, used the ground to support his weight, and that's unfortunately it's a penalty for the Reds.
See that headgear just fly off.
Yeah, it's a fair
hit. Got to be a good indication of how hard these guys are hitting. Queensland ball. Ma'afu ready to go. Lineouts have been consistent.
Ooh, lucky.
They've saved it.
Oh. Some offside.
The seven ball there. Offside. Queensland ball. Good save.
Great hands.
Got to get over. Ma'afu now. Scott Young. He's just always there.
75 runs today, I reckon.
Midfield, 22 meter mark.
Gee, how's good Stewart?
Thomas Stewart. Going for the run. He's going on his own. He's been stopped.
Oh, it's on.
5 metre mark. Just on the 15 metre mark and the 5. Queensland ball coming back to midfield. Ma'afu trying all he can.
Is that Rebels? No. Big Hockings.
Hockings.
Try time.
Try time. Try time by the big Harry Hockings. Number 5, right lock.
Just put some dazzling footwork on there.
Great work there by the forwards.
I think the Rebels are expecting another run just straight up the guts, but he's put some great footwork on and he's gone straight through.
For a second row, mate, he's done really well
today.
Done
very well.
That has taken the score up now to Queensland, under 20s, 25. Melbourne trailing on 10.
Yeah, it's
good footwork there.
It's been the first 10 or 15, the Rebels really stuck it to the Reds, but they've since dominated possession, they've dominated territory, and Stewart and Nusafora really controlled the game well, and tries like that are just a result of good team play. The forwards have dominated, and when you have your forwards going forward, ironically like that, it's really hard to stop.
It's just good to see the consistency from the forwards of the Queensland side. You know, they're just there. Sam Scott, you know, like Angus Scott Young, great work.
Just queuing up, to run the footy. There's no one shirking the task at all, and it's really good to watch.
Conversion here now. Successful. Harry Nusafora. Score is Queensland 27. Melbourne Rebels trail on 10. What a try. Harry Hockings has to be proud of that try. It's not every day you see footwork from
my second row,
second row like that.
No, very good.
Definitely has to be impressing the coaches here.
So 90 seconds left now. In the first half. As it comes back to Hunt.
Hunt takes the ball.
Great run. Oh, he's botched it though. It's another failed exit by the Reds. Third time this half. They've two to Hunt and one to, I think it was Scott Young who trucked it up and had a penalty awarded against him for not releasing. So they've got to work on that.
Definitely the penalty count is too high for such a young and early kind of game, early in the game.
Yeah,
you know?
In that aspect of the game, it's not cool. They're playing well in other parts, but it's obviously not how you want to start the game with your exit strategy, which is something that's coached
On a brighter note, the scrums and lineouts have been pretty consistent, which is always a good thing.
Of course.
Scrum here, Melbourne ball. Left wing, fullback Melbourne.
Oh, well done.
Good palm.
He's left it behind, though.
Queensland just couldn't stop. They've got a turnover now. Queensland ball on the left-hand side of the field. About 15 metres out of their own try line.
Oh, he's scrubbed up. It's not his best kick of the day, New Sephora.
Definitely not, especially pulling out some blinders earlier on. I see a line out, Melbourne's line out.
It's the last chance here. Siren will go shortly. Great offload. Oh, how the hands.
Melbourne trucking it up on the right-hand side there. Coming back on the midfield. Good defence there by Queensland. It's just not allowing them to come in.
Thought Hooper was over that.
Oh, unfortunate drop ball. We've got a, the ref has called a penalty awarding to Melbourne.
Yeah, I think one of the Reds players clearly not through the through the gate there. Coming in from the side or even from the other side of the ruck, I think.
We'll see what he chooses to do. We've got another Melbourne Rebels player down. And we did see that earlier. We had another... We had a Melbourne player stretchered off in the first minute of the game.
Who is that? I'm not sure who that is, yeah. Are they taking the shot here?
It looks like they are. We are into the first... We have finished the first half. Unofficially. Yep, he's still down. He's not moving. You can see some arm movement there. The Melbourne team just standing back.
So what's your thoughts on the first half, mate?
Mate, the first half was pretty good. It was it was kind of even each side. Obviously, the Queensland team getting the edge off, especially with a lot of their forwards. Obviously, just killing it, rucking it up, consistent, sort of not backing down. And you can see a lot of them blowing too. So, you know, really... A really good ups for them, and obviously Harry Nusafora kicking has just been amazing to complement that, which is good. Sometimes those combinations, obviously, as I said earlier, they don't go well together. But mate, it's just been some pretty good rugby. Melbourne have been consistent. I can see a few holes in their rucks, but look, they're still in the game. It's only 27-10, so you know, second half might be a different story, especially changing sides. So.
Yeah, there is a bit of wind. I don't know how much of a factor it's been, but yeah, I think Harrison Goddard and Jack McGregor at 9 and 10, respectively, they've both been really good. They just need to kind of slow it down a touch and get Angelo and Hunter Paisami into it. I think Clarkson's been really good down back, but yeah, I think they just need to get their backs into it a bit more, who are some big boys and putting on some big shots in defence. Goddard with the kick.
Penalty kick successful. That will take the score now to Queensland under 20s 27. Melbourne Rebels under 20s 10. That is the halftime break. We're just watching.
Let's go to 13, I think, mate. 27-13.
27-13. The Queensland under 20s team is leading. Sam, your thoughts on the first half? Your predictions for the second?
Oh, I think... The Reds are well on top, and I think they'll continue that if they can continue picking up some good, consistent ball. But yeah, I think the Rebels just need to sort of slow things down a bit in attack, let McGregor run the show, and pick up from there. So yeah, mate, it's been some good footy so far, and a great start to the under-20s tournament, hasn't it?
It has. It's great to start, especially here, right here in sunny Brisbane at Crosby Park, home of the Brethren. It's pretty exciting. We've got some big rugby coming up today, so yeah, stay tuned for all of that. But look, today today we will be watching... Stay tuned, coming up, we'll have the second half shortly.
Hello and welcome back to the second half of the opening game of the Super Under 20s second inaugural annual competition. My name is Sam Phillips. Alongside me is Simi Kefu. We are about to kick off here. The Reds are leading the Super. The Queensland Under 20s are. Reds Under 20s are 27 to 13 in front over the Melbourne Under 20s. It's been pretty much all Queensland the last 25 minutes. They've really dominated territory and possession, and they'll be hoping to continue that in the second term. Simi, welcome back, mate.
Thanks for having me again. Yes.
Ducked off there, just got back.
Got back.
Never early, never late, right on time.
Toilet breaks.
We're back underway through Hamish Stewart, and the Reds have won the ball there through Harry Hockings. Here's new Sephora out to Mafu. Has been very industrious early. New Sephora looks left. Oh, he spilt it. And the Rebels have got some turnover ball here, so let's see if they spin it wide.
See, the Rebels have lined up pretty evenly out in the back line there. They were ready to take it.
It's a second handling error for New Sephora today. He's been really good with the boot, really good off the tee. Yeah, he's got a couple of handling errors around the base of the ruck, and even one when he was standing at 10, so he'll be looking to fix that. But here we go, about to pack down for a scrum where the Rebels are starting to sort of waver a bit there. They were good early. The Reds really started to shake them up in the back half of that first half.
And I think they've got the Rebels on that back foot at the moment. And so I think their strategy would be for this next sort of 5-10 minutes would just to be try and get the ball down the other end of the field, no matter what it is, no matter what game plan it is. They need to keep that pressure on, which is what they haven't been able to do. Obviously,
definitely.
Queensland has just been consistent in their defence. So the Rebels haven't been able to get there.
It's a big scrum. Goddard now gets it out. Trucked it up through the middle there. He's got out a look for McGregor at the back here as he darts, and he sends it long.
Clear kick here.
It's going to be Jaden Amanu who's going to return it.
Good catch, good save there.
Chip and chase effort. It's not the best option though. It's a good hit.
Good hit. Unfortunately, couldn't make that tackle. A little bit too high there.
He's got out looking to his right. Great tackle.
A lot of picking up in that scrum today. In those tackles.
Martha could be in a bit of trouble. That's a great run by McGregor.
Good line there.
It's a great
good
pass too.
There.
A bit slightly forward, but we're okay with that. And that could be a penalty there, the Reds. Yeah.
Good pick up there by Maher.
And Mafu.
Lani.
Mafu and Jaden Amanu there, well over the pill. Mafu has been absolutely fantastic today. He's been one of the Reds' best, arguably one of the best players in the park. And he's won his team a penalty.
Certainly proved that today as well. See the kick go out.
Stewart looks at the line. It'll be a Reds line out. As you said, all first half, Simi. Marfa's been nailing those throws.
The whole line out from start to finish has just been great. They've even picked up on their mistakes as well with that long pass at the back as an option. We'll see here. They go to midfield.
Stewart across to Scott Young, who's been very, very good, along with Hooper, who's over the back of that rock there. Sephora looks left again. It's another drop ball for the Reds. They won't be happy with that. They haven't started the second half well. So now it's Scott Ard's turn for the Reds. The Rebels, sorry. Great ball. Got out of the back for McGregor, who sends it long. That's kind of just a well-placed chip kick, that. Bit of a 9-iron. This is Jaden Namanu. So sums up his options and sends a nice kick.
Nice kick, nice option there.
Well into the Melbourne half. Showing he can do it all today, Jaden. He's run well, he's defended well, and he's put in a really good kick there. So he's in the Reds full squad, and he's a really good talent, and I think keep playing like this, he's definitely a chance of getting on that Reds bench sometime this year.
And it really shows with some of the decisions that he's been making down in the back there. So, you know, obviously it hasn't gone unnoticed.
No, definitely not. So the Rebels come away. It's a great pass and they're away. Puts the big...
Good step, and he's gone down.
It's a good tackle there. Will Edie coming across. Oh, great work by Hooper. Great work. Harry Hooper muscles his opponent over the line.
He's been great today.
But he's been penalised for a high shot. Let's have a look at that. I don't know about that one.
It's a bit unlucky, I think, that shot. Let's see.
So McGregor's going away. Kicks it.
We'll see the replay here.
Oh,
I don't know about that one.
Slipped up late, but yeah. Very contentious call. Don't know if that throw was straight. It's fallen in the hands of Scott Young anyway. Stewart goes wide to Hunt. Hunt across field to Sammy Edwards. Now it's Nemanja's turn to show what he's got.
He didn't have the ball. He's still got tackle. The ref has put his hand up for that.
Really good hands by the Reds backs there. Again, Hamish Stewart, really impressive. Just showed good initiative to get the ball wide out to Hunt early. Who used Riley and Sammy Edwards out there as well. Jade Namani just didn't quite get that last option right.
The Reds have done really well just to clear the ball out of their half. Unfortunately, it has come back in this instance. But look, they're clearing the ball out really, really well. And I don't see any problem. They'll just gel together and keep that pressure on. And it'll eventually come.
So Goddard looks to run himself at the back of the line out. Leaving a fresh halfback. And McGregor has to look over his head for that one. But that's a great run.
Big unit there.
The Rebels still going forward. Bit impressive, Jack Farrell, the open side for the Rebels. Hunter Paisami there with the run. Oh, it's a good bump. Oh, but he's lost it. Right, it looks like...
Will take that ball.
Liam Wright could be in a bit of trouble there after that hit. He's absolutely crunched by Rebels player there. Just throwing his body into it.
We've got someone down.
Yeah, Liam Wright, the skipper, I think. Better start to the second half by the Rebels.
Definitely. I think they really want this second half. Look, and obviously they're trailing, but every chance that they get, they're trying to bring the ball back up into the Queensland half.
Good physicality by their forwards, which they sort of lacked in that last 25 minutes, and I think that's really shown here for them in that early. They've come out early in this second half and really given it to the Reds forwards, who really had dominated that last 20 minutes of the first turn.
Yeah, and they did really well in doing that as well. The Rebels have come on as a sort of new fresh face in the forwards in this half, which is good to see, contesting Queensland's really tough forwards. Got another player down. We've had a few players down today.
It's good to see Liam Wright there get back up from that. He's obviously copped a stinger, as they call it. He's back up.
Staying on.
Ready to go. Showing a bit of spirit. So it'll be Nusafora who feeds here. So a scrum for the Reds. It's been pretty dominant so far. Good shove, Rebels. It's now Hunt's turn to truck the ball up. It's a great run. And now for Stewart.
Good clear kick there. We'll see Samisi Tupou pass midfield, clear out. And again.
Good tackle.
And that's what we were talking about earlier. The Queensland team has just come back every time and put that ball back in the Melbourne half.
Mm.
And they've done a good job every time.
Goddard's quick tapping his away here. So I'm spitting out the back and McGregor now has got the ball. Oh, nearly another intercept by McGregor. threw that earlier one to Sam Edwards, who scooted away for a try, and I think he had a flashback there when he let go of that.
I think he's hungry for another one.
Big Will Eady this time on the other side of the park. We've got another injury timeout here.
Here it is. Nearly. Ooh. Oh, just missed.
Will Eady trying to outdo Sam Edwards on that right sideline.
He was faced by winger Missy Tupou, who has dominated in the GPS system here, right here in Brisbane, now plays for the Melbourne Rebels under-20s program, in the under-20s program, and also in the Super 15 program as well. Good to see the Brisbane-based players doing well in other states.
There's just so much talent here in Queensland that sometimes not everyone can get a crack, so
yeah.
That's why it's advantageous to have all these other franchises at hand. And Melbourne, in their own right, were superb last year. They played lost to the Reds in the final, but to outdo a main rugby star in New South Wales, great effort.
Another player down, number 6, Richard Clift. Obviously, we've had a few players down today, especially in the first minute of the game.
I think he's okay.
He can stretch it off. We haven't received an update just yet on how he's doing.
So we'll pack down again here. See the Rebels who have come out and the scrum's in better in the second half. Let's see if they can get back some front football now.
Especially the Rebels forwards really showing a strong display in this first sort of 9 minutes of the second half.
Definitely. It's great hands by McGregor as he looks wide.
Oh, had that inside look. Didn't come off.
Good tackle by Hunt. Got up. Big hit. Scott Yarn.
Been instrumental in that forward, in Queensland's forward pack. Marfu.
Nine on here. Jordan Lenak. Oh, I don't know if he can do that. He's standing.
Nice try.
Halfway on the other side of the ruckies. A big swing in hand. So he's been penalised there. Big 17 for the Rebels. And Manny Miafau. It's Stuart to look for the sideline. Referee just having quick chats with the Rebels here about. As you can hear,
see the ref giving them a warning.
Yeah. It's a bit of your discipline creeping in.
It's good to see the desperation in the teams. How bad they really want it.
Good kick by Stewart. So important from kicks like that to try and get within the 10 to 5 metres out. So you can really, if you want to set up a rolling ball, you can. If you want to go off the top or line out and give your back some clean ball, you can. So let's see what the Reds choose to do.
Definitely, especially with the Queensland line out doing so well today. And again, work. Here we've got...
He's Hoopert. He's got a...
Harry Hoopert. He scored off the back of the line out.
Oh, he's lost it. Jeez. Looks like he was going over there.
Mate, he had the momentum. I see a substitution for Melbourne. We've got number 20 warming up. Benjamin Collins. Let's see shortly who he's coming on for.
Here's Hooper. He trucked right over the top of the defender. But as he looked to dive out, he just fell short.
It's good to see the Queensland team really showing all of them, using all of their moves in the line-out, not just sticking to the basics. They use that front runner move, that number one spot in the line-out, and then they've done Hooper running off the back of it.
Massive shove by the Reds. They go right through Scott Young.
We also see Pat Tafa warming up as well.
But they've been penalised here.
Alongside Alex Horan.
Alex Horan, son of Tim.
Son of rugby legend Tim.
Just not releasing there, the Reds. They got some scrappy ball out the back of that massive scrum and they just couldn't hang on to it. So unlucky, but the forwards will be happy with their performance in the scrum there. Now the Rebels have a chance to get some territory. They've been stuck in their own half for the last 4 or 5 minutes.
We're in the 13th minute in the second half. Melbourne's line out.
It's a Goddard across to McGregor. Oh, it's a big step. He's gone straight through there. Hunts up Paisami. McGregor again looks for that sideline. It's Nomanu now. Great run. Here's Lennart. Oh, it's a big run there. And Patrick Taffa. Oh, huge hit on Angus Blythe. And there's some, I think it might have been a head clash there.
I think I felt that.
Yeah, that was bad.
That sounded like a bit of a head clash. We'll see the replay here. Oh.
Yeah, Angus Blythe. Right. It was literally not a point of contact before they smacked heads.
Wow.
It's an enormous hit. And the Rebels, I'm not quite sure who that Rebels defender is yet, but he's in a world of hurt at the moment.
Again, two more players down. It's been an interesting day today.
Yeah, plenty of this one. There's been one serious injury, but outside of that, most of them have been okay. So hopefully he's all right here.
What a good way to start the Super 20s series. Unfortunately, we've had a few injuries today.
Yeah, there's definitely no lack of physicality.
It's good desperation. Goes to show how much they really want it.
So they're calling for the stretcher now, which is unfortunate to see. I think he's going through some concussion protocol. Both players are.
Let's have a look at that replay one more time.
It's Blythe.
You can see the connection there. You can see the Melbourne Rebels player just sort of bracing his head after this collision right here. He just goes down and then he's got his hands over his head. Yep, definitely a head clash. Got a Queensland player coming off, and coming on is Musi Ganita.
So Blythe trotting off with a extraordinarily sore head, I think. And yeah, as you said there, Simi, Ganita will be coming off for him. He'll place him in the second row.
See a bit of blood there on Blythe.
He's been good today, Blythe. Him and Hawkins both been really good in that second row. Hawkins, in particular, at the top of that line out, is doing some really good work. But yeah, Blythe's been great. So it's sad to see him go, but when you get a head knock like that, it's not likely you'll be sticking around for too long.
Go down into a scrum. Melbourne ball. Queensland ball.
So packed down.
Scrums have been pretty good today.
Yep.
Now it's no resets.
Oh, it's a great play. And it's a great tackle there as well on Lennak. Manu at the back of the ruck. It's across to Hawkins. Looks for Marfu, who's trying to spill it across there and spilled in the hands of Josh Nassar.
Good defence there by Melbourne.
Stewart. It's a chip, but it's not a good one.
Missy Tupou got that step.
Edie's over the top of the ball here. Edie's got it. Oh. Gee, I thought he was on his feet there. Had a rush to the ball, but he's been penalised. So McGregor will look the other way and try and clear. It's a nice. Oh, is it going to go out? Yes, it is. It's a nice kick.
Good kick by Melbourne.
All the way down to the opposition 22. This is the first time they've been up here for a long time, Simi. So let's see if they can get some points on the board.
It has. They really need to set their line up. obviously Queensland is just killing it on the line out, so they really need to produce something out here. Push forward with a bit of momentum. Simple two-man line out, which is great.
You're going to maul it up here.
Going to the maul, it didn't come out. The ball has gone back.
So got out across to McGregor. Back to McGregor. Oh, be a knock-on off the Reds there.
In the tackle, knock-on.
Good defence there by Alex Horan, who had did come off the line. Not too early.
But it was really involving Angelo Liapupe and Hunter Paisami in the second half here. Getting some good ball. McGregor's feeding them, and the Reds are having a bit of trouble defending them. So, yeah, it's good to see them getting involved. As we said at halftime, that's kind of what we needed to see from them. So I got out of feed. This Rebel scrum with 25 minutes to play. So Goddard looks to his left and he's got
what through. A good step.
Great clean out. Hands on the ball there, so they had to go. So Goddard will look to his right. Great tackle by Hawkins.
Good work by again. Hawkins.
McGregor at the back to Angelo. He's now Paisami and he's lost it. Back though, says the referee, as it looks like Alex Horan there with the footy. And now Lenak looks to Cleve. He's kicked it straight up in the air. It's anyone's ball here. Edie's going up. Oh, great tag.
Good receive by Missy Tupo. Offload off to the left wing.
Goddard trots over. And start again. Oh, he's left behind.
Unlucky.
You can see he was tired running over that breakdown. He's left behind.
He did do the hard work earlier on. He just needed a bit of a break. Needed a bit of support, I think.
Good passage of play there, though, from both sides. Centers from the Rebels really, really working hard for McGregor outside there. So they've really improved in the second half. They're in front in the second term. So the Reds haven't put any points on the board, and they'll be hoping that the Rebels can continue to play like that.
That sun has just come out as well.
Yeah, banging. So Lenak feeds the ball. Big Rebel scrum. Very big scrum. And they've won a penalty against the feed. Huge from the Rebels.
Good work there. You can see that they really came together on that scrum. They were talking, they were loud. Which is good. It's awarded them a free line out here on Queensland's.
So McGregor for the line here. We're looking for that 5 metre line. It's well short of that, but they'll be. It's Rebels throw here. Get the back and Scott Young cleaned it up. The steward will look to clear.
Good turnover by Queensland.
He's got a serious counter on him here, Stuart. It's a good take by Dongy. He's been good since he's come on. That's going to be a bit too long here. Oh, he's lucky. Has it gone dead? No.
Still in. Hamish Stewart there with the ball.
So the Reds clear. It's a nice kick again from Stewart.
So they've been doing some pretty good clear kicking.
Paisami now, he's not slowing down. Oh, has he got a release there? No. So Paisami keeps going, gains another 5 metres now. Goddard looks to his right. It's McGregor. At the back to Angelo. Good cover defence there by the Reds. Goddard again. McGregor, he's found some space and he's put in a good kick, and there's Tupu. Oh,
good kick out. around the 10-metre line on the Queensland's try line, just 10 metres out.
Edie looking for a penalty there, but I think the ball had well and truly passed the sideline before there was any interference by Tupu. So Marfa will need to get this throw right. And he does
again. He has again.
Gee, he's been good.
Queensland lineup's just absolutely killing it today.
This man's been good too, Scott Young. He'll take the back again to Stewart. He uses that big right foot. Clear it. It's ended up 30 metres out from the Reds line. Throw to Callum Kent. Let's see what the Rebels can do now. Still in the Reds half. Been camped here for the last 5-10 minutes easy. Clean ball.
Good contest there by Queensland. Melbourne too good.
Probably should have got rid of that. He had time and he didn't. As Hungano, who's been a bit quiet in the second term. Kent at the back to McGregor. The chips and chased. It's fallen in the arms of Ryder. But there's been a penalty. So Dylan Riley, that was, who collected that ball. But again, the Reds unable to clear their half. So the Rebels will have another chance now. A try here, and it's definitely game on here, Simi.
You see a lot of the players blowing a lot. Obviously, we haven't got long to go.
18 minutes.
Got less than 20 minutes left on the clock. And a lot of the players now are just working off drive. Good release by Goddard. Midfield run there. And they're resetting up back on the left-hand side.
McGregor. Oh, he's in trouble if he gets held up here.
Ready for support.
To Maul. And I don't think that's coming out.
Yep, the referee's called it.
Good footy by the Reds.
This will tee up for a good kick. A good clear kick for them. Get it out of their half.
Yeah, that was good. There's no better play that sort of gets a team up than a defensive play like that. And McGregor came to this left side on a switch, but had a couple of players overrun him. And from that point on, he was in major trouble and he couldn't get to ground. And the forwards from the Reds really just held him up. And that was game over. So let's see if I can clear that off now. Fourth time lucky.
I must say that this is a new Rebels forward pack that we are seeing in this second half. They've done really well to hold their own.
Here's Horan. Great run.
Good run by Horan.
Taking the ball out now. Here's Stewart.
Clear there by Stewart. Heading for Missy Tupo. Passing into that midfield and passing it again.
Really good in the second half here by Sami. The ball's at the back there for Angelo to clear. He looks for Goddard. He sends the ball infield. Well, it was 45 metres out from the Reds line. McGregor. It's money ball
here,
out here.
We've got an overlap here.
2-0 if he gets it out. Well done, Bilidi.
Well done.
Oh, I think he's judged that he's knocked this down deliberately, but I don't know if he has.
Let's see what he's going to call.
He did deny a line break and no genuine attempt.
Let's just have a look at that replay.
So he's gone. Will Edie has tried to hit it up in that replay.
I don't know how he's saying call it.
The referee's saying that he doesn't agree with that vision that we've just seen, and he sent Will for 10 minutes in the bin. So that could be a real game changer there, Simi.
And look, this is they're really going to take advantage, or they really should take advantage of this one player down. 27-13. They haven't got long to go to really come back into the game. We've got 14 points to make up for. They're in the perfect position to do so. 10 metres out from the Queensland's try line. This is their line out.
So they're infield now. And Goddard looks at McGregor.
Both line outs on both teams seem to be pretty consistent, pretty strong.
It's a great run there by big Manny Miafau. It's a turnover though for the Reds and they're away. Oh, Horan tried to get rid of it, but he couldn't. He's hit it straight into the arms of Clarkson there for the Melbourne Rebels. Here comes Angelo down that right wing. Now Goddard looks infield. He's got a bit of scrappy ball at the back, though. So it's cleaned up.
And not far.
Great D again by the Reds. Really good work. They've just scrapped and sort of pushed their way to some messy ball for the Rebels there, who weren't able to capitalise on some really good field position again. So,
and this is the one opportunity for Melbourne to really turn things around. You know, they've got the advantage, they've got an extra player on the field, they've only got 10 minutes to really, really prove themselves that they can really come back into this game. We've only got 14 minutes left in this game today, so there's no better time like the present. See the Rebels take this scrum.
So Goddard now looks to his left. McGregor. Oh, it's a great ball. Deceptive off to Clarkson, who's gone through. But he's not going to score yet. He's pulled down 2 metres out from the Reds line. Goddard looking to his left, looks to his right. Oh, and they've spilt it. Oh. That's nearly falconed him.
Some unlucky.
The Reds
play there.
Did not shirk that then, and they've really just, again, have aimed up defensively. Some great work. Great ball, though, by McGregor to put Clarkson through. Just couldn't quite get there. A great cover tackle. And the ensuing phase, Goddard's pass just off, but you've got to take that if you're Valawi Famasuli. You've got to take that. So the Sydney Uni boys warming up in the corner.
Getting ready for their game next.
Against University of Queensland. Before the big one, the Sarvo, Timmy, brothers, up here against Norths from Sydney.
Should be a good game.
You're ripping, mate. It's a good red scrum. Scott Young tells us about his 10,000th run.
He's had a couple, hasn't he?
He looks at the back. Oh, Stewart's left it behind, but he's still going to be able to clear it. Oh, look at that.
Good pick up.
What a kick. He's dropped that ball, turned around, and still managed to kick it out 40 metres from his own line. An absolute cannon of the right boot, that boy. Still in the Reds half, though. I don't think we've left the Reds half in a good 15 minutes.
No. It feels like. They've had every opportunity, and that 10 minutes is slowly getting smaller and smaller. Especially with the...
So it's a Rebels lost ball off the top of that line out. Again, the Reds, as you said earlier, contesting those line outs really well.
They've been pretty consistent on the offensive line outs. And the defensive, they've just sort of cleaned up. They've sort of picked one or two line outs from Melbourne. As we saw Will Eady walk off for an apparent knockdown. He's off for less than 10 minutes now. It'd probably be around six left.
As Jordan Linnack feeds the ball. Comes left for Stewart. Cuts Horan out. Goes straight through to Wiley. Who's been good this afternoon. Still going. Linnack looks left again. It's that man Scott Young. Come across field now. Dummies to Hooper. It's Patrick Tafa. He's come on the last 10 minutes.
Harry Hooper having a marvellous game today.
Third game.
He's just been everywhere across the ditch.
Horan. I'm not sure about that option. Here's your man Tupu. It's coming to us. Oh. It's on the Rugby.com.au balcony up here.
There's no screens. They've taken the screens away. No windows. Pretty good aircon flow around here as well.
So the Reds looked to have some territory back in this game now. Another great throw by Marfu. Stewart goes out the back for Horan. He looks wide to Namanu, and it's a 2-on-1 situation out here. Here's Sammy Edwards down that left wing. He's put an infield kick, but it's been charged down, and away the Rebels come now through Clarkson.
The Rebels back line lining up again. They really need to use that line. They've got nobody here in front of them. The Queensland team is just... They need to go wide.
Here they come. Oh, and they've put it down.
Every opportunity.
Literally four players standing outside. Big Hungana there.
Unlucky.
Spilt it at the last moments.
I've seen a lot of those today as well. I don't know whether it's the heat, the wind, probably because they're just absolutely bashing each other. But we've seen a lot of drop ball today, especially Melbourne. Especially when they need all these opportunities to get back. We've got 9 minutes in the game left.
So the Reds look to pack down again. It's territory for the first time, which feels like all half. Let's see what Stewart and Co can do. Scott Young's got out the back and he peels
on
off
his
right.
Own.
Back to Lenak, who's got Namanu. One on two situation. Back to Marfu. Another bustling run by him.
Harry Hooper looking for a run. Passed on.
Stewart's going to have to go to ground with this. Lenak comes right. Scott Young. 20 metres out from the Rebels' line.
Another run by Scott Young.
There's Gunita. And here comes that pick and drive, which we've seen so often for the Reds' 20 so far today. Scott Young again.
Really using it in that first half of the game, and they're using it again here.
Penalty advantage.
They just keep on going. Melbourne having no answer for this. Only 5 metres away from the Melbourne try line. The ref has awarded a penalty.
Oh, someone's going to the bin here. Professional foul.
That's two in a row. Scrum.
Is that Kent?
Yep. Points.
I think it might be. The hooker?
Not sure, yeah. Yeah, with the headgear.
Nine.
I'm going to go for the kick here. This will take Queensland up to 30. Extending that lead.
So new Sephora off, and therefore Stewart will take the shot. It's been really good today, Stewart. Probably the best of the Reds backs, I think.
I must say everybody has really pitched in. They've played both backs and forwards have pitched in.
Definitely.
To really, obviously, look at the scoreboard, you know, nearly 17 points ahead. Harry Hooper, the prop, Scott Young, doing a really good job. Penalty kick successful. That'll take Queensland under 20s up to 30. Melbourne Rebels will trail on 13. Got 17 point difference. Less than 7 minutes on the clock.
It's a pretty big thing considering they've got one man less to have worked their way out of their own half and to put 3 points on the board. And they're in a plus three situation with one man down. So it's been a good start to that period. It's a knock on there from the Rebels from the kickoff. And we're going to have a red scrum.
I think Melbourne is just a little bit lacking in fitness.
We're going to need to make sub because that's...
Not getting around the field, not getting around the pitch. Those rucks look a little bit sloppy.
This is almost simply the hooker, so we need to make sub. Seven and a half.
Got a Shaden Folau going back on. Going on.
Yeah,
for Melbourne.
Due to that, Kent Sinbin, he's got to come on. I think it's one of the back rails will have to come off here.
Under 20s, open law. It's not under 19.
We've got the same numbers though. Okay. Sorry.
So we'll just get a off trots.
Big scrum here, big scrum.
Queensland ball.
Richard Clift off for that. For this scrum while Kent's in the bin. In place of Shaden Folau, as you said earlier. Simi. So the Reds pack down again.
Melbourne really need to come up and put some pressure on in the last, you know, obviously we've only got less than 5 minutes left to go.
See, Stuart looks for that right boot again. Not his best kick of the afternoon. It'll fall in the arms of Dongy. And he's going to look to just take Namanu on. Steps inside.
Good stepping.
Great run.
Just stepped four Queensland players.
Horan goes with him and takes him to ground. So out comes Goddard to the left now, McGregor. And it's a forward pass from the Rebels 10.
Unlucky there for Missy Tupou.
He was away there. There's a couple more subs here coming on now. So got Lorenzo Skelton just coming on for the Reds.
23.
And also seeing Lloyd Gorman, Matthew Fessler.
See Harry Hooper coming off as well.
One of the all-time prop games today from him, I reckon.
Definitely. Look, absolutely. He's just consistent. He's been there. How many runs has he done? Like 1,000?
Him and Scott Young, yeah.
And he's putting some big hits on as well. And it's those it's the 1%ers that he's been doing around the pitch that have really, you know, contributed to the team's obvious, you know, lead.
Yeah, correct. So here we go. Lenak at the back. Stuart. Horan. Onto that man, Skelton, who's beat one. He's given it to Namanu, who's away. It's a 2-on-1 situation. Sammy Edwards outside, but Namanu's going to go himself. It's a great cover tackle there by the Rebels, and around they come. The ball was out. So it's a Reds line out now. Up the top they go to right, and they're going to try and maul this all the way to the try line. They're 10 metres out as they drive through. It's advantage, so Stewart takes it up the middle. Rebels might have to roll away there. We've had a knock on, so we're going to go back. I think Hanga has been penalised there for the second time this half. Collapsing that more. You can hear the brothers faithful in the background there. Haven't played their games this morning.
It's a big day for them, especially having all this attention right here on Crosby Park at their home field.
A few beverages on the hill, Jimmy?
Yes, been known to have a few up there a while ago. great venue here as well.
Oh, it's great. No better place to watch some footy than Crosby Park, mate.
Some nice grounds. Just ignore that scoreboard in the background. Queensland is on 30. Melbourne is trailing on 13.
Scorekeeper asleep at the wheel here.
Yeah. It's not our guys.
No.
It's not our guys. I've already checked. Shout out.
So the Reds opting to go to the scrum here from a penalty, which is interesting. They have been dominant the last couple since Kent's gone off. The Rebels hooker for that sin bin, so not surprising to see them opting for this. Reset here. So as we wind up here, Simi, your thoughts on the match so far, mate? 15 seconds to play.
Mate, I have to give it to the Queensland forward pack. Obviously not being biased, being forward, but they've done really good today. Offensively, defensively, around the pitch. Props to Harry Hockings, definitely Angus Scott Young, and obviously Harry Hooper has done really well.
As they win another scrum penalty here.
Ma'afu also, you know, has done it. It's been a pretty good sort of collaboration between all, especially having, you know, on the end of Harry Nusafora and Hamish Stewart. They've just done really well. And I think for Queensland, it's a good eye-opener to see, you know, to see how their sort of season is going to unfold, especially come taking what they can from this game. So, yeah, positive things for Queensland under 20s. Melbourne, not a bad display.
No, they'll be happy, but obviously we'd prefer to get the win. As they come out to Stewart, he goes himself. McGregor tackles him aptly. Now it's that pick and drive that we've seen all day. Reds, forwards, tracking it up. Halfback Lekin just pushing, pointing, directing. As the Reds again come forward now, right next to that post. This is quite, he might have dropped that. Yeah, he has.
Again, and he's knocked that on.
Not the way they would have liked to end this one. But that should do it.
Now he's going to play the scrum.
No, we're going again. So as we wind down here, just receiving some medical attention again in the dying stages of this one. But it's been a really good performance today from the Reds. They'll be underfed last year in the 20s. No, it looked like they're a side that can do it again this year. They've really put together a performance that they can be proud of, and I'm sure we'll hear from their coaches after the game. Brad Thorne after the game, so it'll be good to hear his take on it. But they've really been, especially that first half, they really dominated physically, and they really gave their backs some good ball. When you have a 10 like Stewart who's really playing at the top of his game, it's a formula that's going to pay off more than not, Simi.
The kicking has just been fantastic today. The clearing out, they're getting the ball out of their half.
So the Rebels' time to pack down now.
We're well past the 80-minute mark. We're on the 82 minutes.
We've got it comes out to Angelo. It's a great run to Pymarcy again. That's a forward pass, and that should do it. I think our clocks might be off here, Sonny.
Yeah, I don't know what the ref is actually, what watch he's looking at.
I think ours are wrong or his are wrong. I'm not sure.
I'm sure the players are good to go. Poor buggers are in this heat. Absolutely scorching here at Crosby Park, home of the brethren. Big day for brothers today.
And that'll do it. The Queensland Reds under-20s have defeated the Melbourne Rebels under-20s 30 points to 13 in the opening game of the Super under-20s. I think we'll have a quick chat with Brad Thorne here coming up. But thanks for watching today. Glad to have your company here on BarTV and Rugby.com.au. We'll stream all the other Super 20s games throughout the competition over the next few weeks. So be sure to tune in. If you can't get to the games or at the suburban parks, then definitely tune in. So, Simi, mate, your take on that. Who would you have in your best 3-2-1, mate?
best on ground?
Yeah, mate. Look, it's hard to say. Harry Nusafora really, you know, he gelled the backs and the forwards really, really well together. Hamish Stewart with those long, clear kicks and getting the ball out of the Queensland half. That also helped and contributed with today's victory. Look, the forwards, I can't give you a name. I just can't. But look, everybody did really well, and it should be pretty, you know, exciting times for Queensland under 20s, because the display that we've just seen was amazing. Melbourne Rebels, nothing, you know, not the best game. A few penalties given away, a few easy penalties here and there. Drop ball, something you probably don't want to go, don't want to have in your first game of Super 20. So they really should really tidy that up and sort of tighten that up a bit.
Yeah, 100% agree, mate. I think there were some really good performances out there for the Reds, guys like Harry Hooper and Angus Scott Young. Jaden Amano at the back was really good, but the best for me was the 10, Hamish Stewart. Really good clearance kicks, really good organisation in attack, and he just looked like a complete 10 out there, so it's really good to see. So I think we're going to hear from Brad Thorne here now.
We'll come back to you with Brad Thorne. We're going to wrap that up for today.
Thanks very much for joining us, guys. It's been a pleasure. And stay tuned to rugby.com.au for all your Super Rugby and World Rugby related content. From Sam Phillips and from Simi Kefu, thanks for watching.